Dear students, welcome to the science class. So in the last class we were discussing about the work and energy topic. In that topic we discussed about the work as well as we discussed about some points about the energy. Right? So that we discussed about the various sources of energy as well as we discussed about the various types of the energy. So in that energy, in this syllabus we are going to discuss about the mechanical energy. In that we have kinetic energy as well as the potential energy. So first we are going to see about the kinetic energy. So what is the kinetic energy here? Kinetic energy here. So identify that what is the kinetic energy. We are going to do an activity. In that activity we are going to take a table. On that table we are going to take a toy car which is connected to by a thread to a weight here, by a thread to a weight. So this is the container. In that container we are going to put some weight or mass, right? And we have some obstacles here. Here is a wooden block, again here is another wooden block, right? Wooden block is there, again here is another wooden block is there, so that it shouldn't go in the backward direction. Now force is applied here like this. The direction of the force will be like this. So what will happen? Initially when you put small amount of weight, it doesn't move. It doesn't going to move. So when you add another amount of weight here, what will happen? This thing, the toy car starts to move in the direction, in the forward direction. Right? Forward direction it is going to stop here. Since there is an obstacle, and it is going to move and it is going to stop here. In the same manner, if I put some more weight here, again I am going to take this toy car to its initial position. After some time I am going to add some more weight here. After adding some more weight here, what will happen? This thing, the toy car speed is going to increase. Whatever it is moving initially, that speed is going to get increased when the weight is also going to get increased. Right? So what will happen when the weight increases here? The speed of this car is going to increase. So what will happen when the speed of the car is going to increase? It is going to move this block, wooden block, up to some distance. Wooden block up to some distance. In the same manner, again I am going to take it to the initial position. Again I am going to put some more weight. What happened? Again then the speed of the car is going to get increased. When the speed of the car is going to get increased, it is again going to move this wooden block, but this time along with this wooden block it is going to move this wooden block also. Right? Up to last point it is moving up to this point, but this time what is happening here? It is moving the wooden block from this point, also this toy car is moving this wooden block also in the forward direction. In the forward direction. Right. If you check here, we already discussed about here the work is doing, work is done here on this wooden block as well as on this wooden block also the work is done. Why work is done here? Work is nothing but what? It is the product of the force into the displacement. So this toy car is applying the force on this wooden block, that means this wooden block is displacing. If this wooden block is displacing, what is happening here? The work is doing here, work is done here. In the same manner, if this wooden block is also moving, what is happening here? Here also a force is applied and there is a displacement of that wooden block is also going to happen. So if both the wooden blocks are moving, what is doing here? The work is done here. Work is done here. So we already know that for doing the work, To do the work, the capability of doing work is nothing but what? It is energy. It is energy. Now see here, what we are doing here, we are just increasing the speed of this vehicle. So initially it is at rest position. After some time, after adding the weight, it starts to move. Because of that movement, it come here and stop here. Again we increase the weight, it is hitting this wooden block. When it hits the wooden block, along with that wooden block, both are moving. So here the work is done here. If the work is done here, that means here the energy transfer is taken place. If the energy transfer is taken place here, from where does that energy is getting? If the work is doing here, the energy is coming from this toy car. In the same manner, in the next position, what is happening here? Both the wooden blocks are moving. So if you both wooden blocks are moving, from where does the work is doing here? They are doing the work, right? Sorry, they are doing the work. If they are doing the work, from where does they are getting the energy? They are getting the energy from this wooden, this toy car. So the toy car getting energy from where? It is getting energy from the continuous motion of this toy car. When the speed of this toy car increases, this wooden block is also moving, this wooden block is also moving. That means this toy car is getting energy from the wooden block. Sorry, toy car is getting energy from the its motion or its speed. Or you can call it as its motion. Right. So whatever the object which is going to get energy from its motion, that energy is nothing but what? It is the kinetic energy. In this case, toy car is getting energy from its motion, that is transferred to the wooden blocks, that energy is nothing but what? It is the kinetic energy. It is the kinetic energy. If you take the example of the bullet also. Right, bullet, if you take that bullet is fired from the pistol, it is going to get inside our body. It is going to pierce our body. If it is piercing our body, from where does that bullet is getting energy? Since it is doing work, what type of work it is doing? It is piercing our body. That means it is doing work and it is getting energy. So from where does that bullet is getting energy? It is getting energy from the its speed, its continuous motion. It's a continuous motion. Because of that continuous motion, it is piercing our body. That means it is getting energy from its motion. Right? In the same way, if you take the example of the ball also. So we are going to throw the ball in the same way. We are going to throw the ball with your hands and it is going to go in the same direction, same way. So, but in some cases the ball is going to break the stumps, but in some cases it doesn't going to break the stumps. Right, what happens here? The ball which is continuously in motion is acquiring energy. It is getting energy. Because of that energy, it is piercing the stumps. But in some cases the ball is not acquiring the energy. Because of that thing, it is not piercing the stump. Right, in the same way, if you take the example of the ball one day, which ball is going to pierce the stumps or it is going to fall, break the stumps? The ball which is moving faster. The ball which is moving slower is not going to break the stumps. But the ball which is moving faster, it is going to break the stumps. So what does it mean? The ball which is moving faster, it is acquiring more energy. Whereas the ball which is moving slower, it is acquiring less energy. Right, again here, the ball which is moving faster is acquiring due to its motion, due to its very high speed. So that energy acquirement is nothing but what? It is the kinetic energy. So just remember, kinetic energy is nothing but what? It is the energy possessed by an object due to its motion. If the object is at rest position, then the kinetic energy amount will be zero. It will be equal to how much? It will be equal to zero. So kinetic energy is nothing but what? It is the energy possessed by objects due to its motion. Right, due to its motion. So next we are going to see about the mathematical form of the kinetic energy. And kinetic energy can be denoted as Ek. It can be denoted as what? Ek. So energy, kinetic energy. Since it is energy, sensor, it is also what? It is the same, it is Joules only. Right. Next we are going to see about the mathematical form of Ek. Mathematical form of kinetic energy. Now let us consider an object. You have to write these points while deriving the mathematical form of the kinetic energy. Let this be the object having the mass m. Like this, you have to write. Let this be the object having the mass m. Initially, it is moving with the velocity u. After the application of the force, it is moving with the final velocity v. Final velocity v, and it is going to cover distance of as. It is going to cover distance of as. So that is nothing but if it is moving, there is a work done on this thing. Work done on this thing. So we have to find out the work done on this thing. Whatever the work it is going to do, that is nothing but the energy acquired by this object. Right? It has the mass m. It is moving with the initial velocity u. When the force is applied, it is moving with the final velocity v, and it is going to cover distance of s. So the total work done here in this object will be what? It is nothing but what? It is equal to w is equal to F into S. The total work done by this object is nothing but W is equal to F into S. So those statements you have to write seeing your textbook. So W is equal to F into S here. Now we know that the kinetic energy is nothing but what? It is due to its motion. So if you see here, we know the formula for F, that is nothing but F is equal to M into A by the Newton's second law of motion. So therefore, F is equal to what? F is equal to M into A. Let this be the equation number 2 and this be the equation number 1. This is by Newton's second law of motion. By Newton's second law of motion. Right. In the same manner, we have two equations for S. Right, that is nothing but in the motion topic we discussed about the two equations for the S. That is nothing but first one is the S is equal to ut plus half at square. Second one is 2as equal to v square minus u square. 2as equal to what? U square minus v square minus u square. So if you check here, in this statement we don't know the value of time. But displacement is given, acceleration is going to come since we have the change in the speed. If there is a change in the speed, there is the acceleration is going to be there. And we have the u value, we have the v value. So that we are going to use this equation. So that equation is equal to, if I take s outside, s is equal to what? It will become v square minus u square divided by 2a. Right, this equation we are going to use now. So by the equations of the motion, what is the S? That is nothing but 2As equal to V square minus U square. So we require S here. Therefore, S is equal to V square minus U square divided by 2A. V square minus U square divided by 2A. Right. So let this be the equation number 2. Let this be the equation number 3, but not 2. Now you have to substitute the equation number 2 and 3 in equation 1. So substitute equation 2 and 3 in equation number 1. Equation number 1. So what does the equation number 1 becomes here? That is nothing but W equal to, what is the value of F here? That is nothing but M into A into what is the value of S here? S is equal to V square minus U square divided by 2A. So it is equal to V square minus U square divided by 2A. So if you get the A get cancelled, then W becomes what? M in the bracket V square minus U square divided by 2. V square minus U square divided by 2. Right. V square minus U square divided by 2. Now take that equation here. W is equal to M in the bracket V square minus U square divided by 2. So whatever the object which we are taking initially, let this be the object at start at rest position. Right, if the object at start it is at rest position, then what will be the initial velocity of that object? that will be equal to 0 only, right? So if the object is at rest position, let the object is at rest, that is nothing but initial velocity that u is equal to how much, it is equal to 0 only. Since at rest position it is not moving, that means the initial velocity we can take it as 0. So if it is equal to 0, if you put the value of u here as 0, then the equation will become w is equal to half into m in the bracket v square minus 0. That is, it is going to give half m v square. Right. So w is equal to what? It becomes half mv square. So here the work done is due to the motion. After that point, it is at stationary position. And here, after that, the final velocity, if you take the final velocity here, this work is done by the motion. It is due to the motion. Whatever the work which is done here, it is due to the motion. So we already know that work done as well as energy both are interlinked. So how much work we are going to do, it is the amount of energy it is going to consume. Right, therefore E is equal to W. So here in this case, instead of W I am going to write Ek. So the amount of work done is nothing but it is amount of energy consumed. So here the energy consumed is due to the motion. So instead of W I am going to write Ek. So that is equal to what? It is equal to half mv square. That is equal to what? It is equal to half mv square. Right, this is the mathematical form of the kinetic energy. This is the mathematical form of the kinetic energy. So always remember, this is one of the greatest equations we are going to see in physics. Ek equal to half mv square. Right, kinetic energy is equal to, which is nothing but half of the product of the square of the velocity to the mass of that object. Right, this is the mathematical form of the kinetic energy. Now see here, another important point in this case only. Now we know that the mass of the object is not going to change. Is it possible that in each and every case mass of the object is going to change? We already know that the mass of the object is unchanged. But weight of the object can be changed. But mass of the object never ever going to change. So if it is constant one, if it is mass is the constant one, we can write Ek is directly proportional to the mass. If we take it as the constant, 1 by 2 is also constant, it is also not going to change. Its mass is also not going to change. If we take it as the constant, Ek is directly proportional to the v square. That is nothing but Ek is directly proportional to the v square. That is nothing but the kinetic energy. This is the important point. The kinetic energy is directly proportional to the square of the velocity. So what does it mean if the velocity changes? That is nothing but if the velocity of object is increased, then the kinetic energy is also going to increase. That is nothing but Ek. If the velocity decreases, the kinetic energy of that thing is also going to decrease. It is also going to get decreases. So if an object is moving, if that speed of that object is increased, that means nothing but it is going to acquire more amount of energy. If the object is slowed down, then that object is going to get reduction in its energy, since velocity is reducing. Or the speed is reducing. Therefore, if we take the example of the ball also, which we have taken initially, if the ball is having the more amount of speed, when it hits us, it is going to hurt us. In the same manner, if the ball is coming towards us with the very slow speed, it is not going to hurt us. For that reason, why? what is the reason there? It is the reason of the speed of the ball. If the ball is speed of the ball, it is going to acquire more amount of energy. If it is acquiring more amount of energy, it is going to do more amount of work. In the same manner, if it is slow in speed, that means it is going to acquire less amount of kinetic energy. If it is acquiring less amount of kinetic energy, that means it is going to do less amount of work. If it is doing less amount of work, when it hits us, it is not going to hurt us. So it is because of the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy. Another thing here, Ek is directly proportional to the V square, we know that. And how much proportion that Ek is going to, that is nothing but kinetic energy is going to increase if the V is also increased. So in this square reason, in this square proportion, if the velocity of that ball is increased by the 2 times, then the kinetic energy is increased, it is going to increase 4 times. So the square of the 2 is equal to 4. So it is increased by 4 times. In the same manner, if it is increased by 3 times, then it is going to increase by 9 times. Since the square of the 3 is equal to how much? It is equal to 9. Now if the velocity is decreased by 1 by 2 times, that is nothing but half, then the kinetic energy is going to decrease by 1 by 4 times. Since 1 by 2 square is equal to how much? It is equal to 1 by 4. So this is about the kinetic energy, and this is the mathematical form of the kinetic energy. Let us take an example depending on the kinetic energy. So see here, an object has mass 15 kg is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second. So what is the kinetic energy possessed by that object? Right, if see here, the mass of the object is given as 15 kg and it is moving with the 4 meters per second. So let this be the object which has the 15 kg mass and it is moving with the velocity of 4 meter per second. So since it is moving, that is nothing but it is getting acquired kinetic energy. So whichever the object which is in motion, they are going to get acquired kinetic energy or energy. So here it is acquiring the energy due to its motion. So we have to calculate that energy. Now therefore, first we have to write down the given data. So mass of the object, that is nothing but m is given as how much, it is equal to 15 kg. Right, then what they are given here, they are given the velocity of the object. So the speed or velocity of the object. Speed or velocity of the object, that is nothing but v is equal to 4 meter per second. Right, so we know that formula for the kinetic energy, so that we have to calculate the kinetic energy here. So the kinetic energy, which is Ek is equal to question mark. Right, therefore we know that Ek is equal to half mv square by the formula. So if you put the values here, half m is how much? 15 into 4. So 52 is 30, 34 is 120, so that 120 joules. So the kinetic energy gained by that object is equal to how much? Which is equal to 120 joules. Which is equal to how much? Which is equal to 120 joules. At last, I come the conclusion that is nothing but the kinetic energy possessed by the object is equal to 120 joules. That's nothing but kinetic energy possessed by the object is equal to 120 joules. Right, so this is the question number 11.3.